Welcome back, DoomTubers, to another pickups video. This one's going to be ass massive once again. But I don't have too many games, so stick around, because we'll talk about those later on in the video. I got tons and tons of stuff I picked up at garage sales and local thrift stores and my public library. A public library was having a sale on VHS tapes, and of course you all know that I kind of collect those, I guess. I wasn't really like aiming to do that, but hey, good movies for a buck or less. I still have a VCR. I can deal with it. I can deal with rewinding, because most of the time I watch the whole movie, so. got lots of VHS tapes, something like 20 movies, something like that. Some books that I need to grab, actually. I didn't pick those up just yet, so bear with me a second. And since I have them in my hand now, I'm going to start with those. Picked up a few books and some audiobooks locally. They're very cheap. I think I spent a quarter each on the books and the audiobooks. So I've got about $1.75 worth of stuff here. Picked up a couple more of the Dragonlance books. I'm actually missing a book. There it is. Picked up a couple of the Dragonlance books. A couple that I missed the first time around. It's Tales Volume 1, The Magic of Kryn is one of them. Tales Volume 2, Kender Gully, Dwarves, and Gnomes. And I picked up... this is called Star Trek 10, adapted by James Blish. It, from what I can understand, reading the cover and stuff, it's like episodes of the TV show adapted to novel form. I think it's like several episodes, six episodes of the TV show adapted into a book. So I picked that up. And then I picked up Children of Dune. And... Dune Messiah. Pick those up. Those are all a quarter each. Then I picked up three audiobooks, like I said. I picked up this one, the first one here. I'm actually not sure if it's like the full book in audiobook form, because on the cover it says dramatized books on cassette. And it's only one cassette, and I have a feeling that the book is longer than one cassette. That's Red Badge of Courage. Still glad to pick this up, though. I'd still like to check it out. And the other two books I picked up, audiobooks, I picked up Michael Crichton's Andromeda Strain. I don't know what this is about or anything, but he's a Jurassic Park guy, and he did a lot of other science fiction, like Sphere and stuff like that. So I decided I'd check that out. And then I also got Mark Bowden's Black Hawk Down. This is actually the one that I started. I started this the other night, just kind of wanting to just check it out, because I had never listened to an audiobook before. I have a few now. I think I got like less than 10 of them, but, you know, a few. And so I decided I would check it out. Set up a cassette player beside my bed and listened to it. I listened to the first half of one tape, one side of one tape, and I think that was about 30 minutes. Pretty good so far. Yeah, it's hard. It spent most of the time just kind of setting you up, setting the area up, you know, and kind of some of the characters and what they were doing and stuff like that. But haven't seen the movie yet either, but figured what the heck, if I'm not going to read the book, might as well listen to the book and then watch the movie just to kind of compare them a little bit. Okay, that does it for the books for now. And let's move on to some movies. Like I said, one of my local libraries was having a sale, 25 cents on all their VHS tapes, so I picked up several. And I also hit up some garage sales and thrift stores and found some cool stuff, some cool VHSs. I don't find that many DVDs at thrift stores and stuff. Occasionally, I mean, and usually the ones that are there are just like, eh, don't really want it, and it's like $3. So, I just kind of keep my eye out for some of these quirky movies, and you'll see what I mean by quirky when I get to some of them, but so far, so good. I picked up a few titles I remember from when I was a kid, one of them being Problem Child. Picked this up at a garage sale. I think I paid $1 for this. Great movie. I loved it when I was a kid. I loved the second one, too, for some reason. I don't know. Just liked him. John Ritter. It's good stuff. And then I picked up Homeward Bound, The Incredible Journey. I can't deny that I love this movie. And, of course, the Pit Bull and I, we share a name. So, whatever. I could never live that down when I was a kid. That the dog, the pit bull from Homeward Bound, and I had the same name. Go figure. Picked up the original Escape to Witch Mountain. This movie is fantastic. I used to watch this movie all the time. This one and the sequel, Return to Witch Mountain, I think is what it was called. And then in the 90s, they remade it, I think, for the Disney Channel. And that one wasn't too bad either. But then I think not too many years ago they made another one with The Rock in it. And I never saw it, but I never felt compelled to either. This one's fantastic, though. So if you haven't seen the original, check it out. This is Land of the Lost. I thought that was pretty cool, so I went ahead and picked it up. Like I said, it was a quarter. So I was like, what the heck? I remember Land of the Lost from when I was a kid. I think this is the... I'm not sure whether this is a movie or if it was like the show, the Nickelodeon show. I think it might be the Nickelodeon show. It says it's volume 2, and which leads me to believe there's only like 2 episodes on it because it's only 45 minutes long. So I think this is like a couple episodes of the show from when I was a kid. Okay, moving on, next stack here. Got several stacks. Kind of wondering how this is all going to work. I guess I'll set them back here. Okay, next up. One I haven't seen yet, but it's one of my very favorite books. Surprisingly, I haven't seen it yet. It's the Henry Fonda Grapes of Wrath. I don't know when this was made. Box says 1997, but I don't think that's right. Because I think it's in black and white. Who knows? Doesn't really matter. It's The Grapes of Wrath. I love the book. Never seen the movie, so I figured I would pick that up. Next up is Rob Roy, with Liam Neeson in it. I actually don't know what this is about. My mom used to watch this when I was a kid, and then she wouldn't let me watch it with her. I wasn't allowed to watch this movie with her. I don't know what was in it that was bad that I wasn't allowed to see, but I sure wasn't allowed to watch it, so I'm gonna check it out eventually now that I own it. And Black Hawk Down, I just talked about this. I actually picked up the audiobook, and then later on in the same store I found the movie, so I went ahead and picked it up. And this is a previewed Blockbuster movie, still got the original Blockbuster sticker like sealing up the box, so it hasn't been washed since it left Blockbuster. And here's a movie that I've seen several times, and I actually have it on DVD, but it's a burned copy, so I went ahead and bought it anyway. It's Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. Love it. Johnny Depp is brilliant in this movie. Hunter S. Thompson book. I haven't read the book, but I want to. I have it, but I haven't read it yet. I know it's a fantastic movie, though, so there it is. Okay, next up is a few that I bought. One of them that I bought on a whim just because the cover looked cool. And it's Charlton Heston. And the cover just made me laugh because I've never heard of the movie. I was talking to my family members about it this weekend. They said it's a good movie, so I will check it out. It's called El Cid. Charlton Heston, Sophia Loren. And I just looked at this cover, and all I could say was, "From my cold, dead hands." I just laughed, because he's holding his sword, like, very similar to his NRA things. So, yeah, there you go, El Cid. It's in one of these dual cases. It's gigantic. It's a 2 VHS movie, and the case is just huge. It's hard to store this case. And I got two others, and I saw these two, and that one was sitting next to it. Two others in those dual cases, and I was going to get these anyway. These, I'm actually not sure which version this is. I wanted to say when I got it that it was the BBC version, but I think this is just some other like made-for-TV version of the C.S. Lewis Chronicles of Narnia. It says WonderWorks Family Movie. So I don't know which version this is, but this is The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. Once again, dual case. So I picked that up, and then to go with it, they also had Prince Caspian and The Voyage of the Dawn Treader. So I picked that up, too. Haven't watched these yet. There's a lot of these movies I haven't watched yet. But I will check these out. I'm a huge, huge Narnia fan, so I will be sure to check both of those out. I really want them to make another Narnia movie. I really, really want to. I don't think it's going to happen. But I want it to. Dawn Treader just left me hungry. Hungry for more. Hungry for more. I bawled my eyes out. It's a good movie. next stack. Got two more stacks here. And I think they get better. So, you know, stick around. I actually haven't heard of this movie, but I don't know how I haven't heard of it, because it's directed by, well, somebody famous. It says directed by, from the Academy Award winning director of Forrest Gump and the Pulitzer Prize winning author of Contact. It is Contact. Jodie Foster and Matthew McConaughey. I don't know actually how I haven't seen this or heard of this yet, but looks pretty good, so I'll check that out. This was a buck. And another movie that I haven't heard of, and this one probably will suck, but I bought it anyway. It's Battlefield Earth with John Travolta. I went and picked that up. And then I got James Spader and Angela Bassett's Supernova. Another one that'll probably suck, but I bought it anyway. Godzilla and versus Mechagodzilla. I had to buy this when I saw it. I was actually kind of excited when I saw it. I don't know why, but I bought it. And I'm taking the plunge and maybe going to watch some of these. Mystery Science Theater 3000. This one is Cave Dwellers. I know nothing about it, and I'm very new to this. To the show, but I figured this would be a good starting point, I guess, if there is a good starting point. I think that's the whole point of the show, is that they're like horrible movies. I'm so unfamiliar with it. It's kind of silly. Next up, just about five more VHS here, and then we'll move on to something else. The original Battlestar Galactica movie, I picked that up. I've never watched either of the shows, the old one or the new one, but I want to. It's one of those things that's on my agenda, so I went ahead and picked up Battlestar Galactica movie. And here's a funny one. I just watched this the other night. It's actually, I looked this up on YouTube. I was searching for some more information about it because it's kind of an obscure title. And I found an episode of Mystery Science Theater 3000 where they were talking about this, you know, where this is the movie that they picked. It's called Fugitive Alien 2 Star Force. And this is a very interesting movie. If you can imagine a combination of the old Godzilla movies meets Star Trek or Star Wars, there you go. It's a combo, bad acting, you know, bad Japanese acting and horrible English overdub. And yeah, here you go. But to me, I mean, this is a personal experience. The movie was not that bad, really. I mean, if you could get past the overacting and the crap overdub, the crap English dub, like, the story and the characters really weren't that bad. I actually sat through this whole thing and kind of enjoyed it. Let me read the back for you. Before Star Wars made a spark, there was Star Force. It's an unlikely intergalactic crew, each forced together for their special skills. a doctor, a beautiful woman, a superhuman wolf raider, and a fugitive alien who knows the galaxy better than any living being must, and they must put aside their personal conflicts. They navigate the astral system in search of the invincible Halcon and his devastating star fleet. It's their job to destroy his ultimate weapon in this all-out war for the stars. The action accelerates at hyperspeed in Star Force. So, if you want to watch the Mystery Science Theater 3000 version of this movie, I know it's on YouTube, so go check it out. Okay, three more here, and I'm actually pretty excited about all three of them. This first one is just a real short one. I think it's just maybe one episode, maybe two, of the original X-Men cartoon. It was on in the early 90s. It is Intermagneto and Deadly Reunions. I think it's two episodes of the show. But what I was excited about was this. Very bottom of the back says, this tape contains an exclusive 5-minute roundtable discussion featuring famous Marvel personalities, including Stan Lee and then a bunch of other people that I don't recognize. So I was excited to pick that up, and I think it cost me like 25 cents, so I was pretty happy to have that. I'd like to find some more of these because I absolutely love the original X-Men cartoon that was on when I was a kid. It's fantastic. I love it. It's on Netflix, so I mean, it's not like I'm hurt to watch it. I've watched, you know, several episodes. I need to finish that, actually. Okay, two more. One of them is one I haven't seen, and I don't know anything about it. And I'm sure it's horrible, because a lot of these in this series are. No offense to the series, because I did like most of them that I've seen, and they all have a certain charm to them, no matter how bad they are. And that's the Friday the 13th series, and this is Jason Goes to Hell. I think this was the last one in the regular series, although I think Jason X came after this one. Not really sure. Yeah, it had to have. Jason X came after this one. Of course, Freddy vs. Jason came after this one. But this is one of those movies that I can remember seeing in the video store, like when I was a kid, or at the grocery store in the video department, and being like scared, but like so intrigued that I couldn't stop staring at the cover. So yeah, I'm kind of excited to watch this just because of that. Like, it's one of those movie covers. They just stuck with me. I can always remember going to one of the local grocery stores with my parents, and while they were in the checkout, you know, checking out all the groceries, I'd be in the movie section, like, staring at the horror section. I'd be staring at this one and, like, Species, the first one I can remember watching or looking at the cover. What was the other one? Child's Play. I can remember looking at those covers and being like so scared, but I couldn't tear my eyes away from it, and just looking at the pictures on the back, just remembering looking at them and being, you know, like freaked out. So yeah, kind of a cool memory of that. This last one is kind of one that I don't hear about too much, but I hear a lot of people knock the first movie, and it's the Blair Witch 2, Book of Shadows. Now, if you haven't seen this or haven't even heard about it, let me give you a brief rundown of what's kind of going on. Consider that the events that happened in the first movie were real. Consider that, like, it really happened. What happens in this movie, this is an actual movie, not a documentary. What happens is these people, these fanatics of, you know, that story, you know, and you know, that lived, you know, in the time that it happened, they go back to the site where it happened, and they get cursed somehow. They get cursed, and then they take the curse home with them, and it, like, you know, like, messes with them, and, you know, lots of people die and stuff. So, you know, it's a completely different experience than the first one. It's actually even a little weird that they call it the Blair Witch 2, but yeah. I have a soft spot for the Blair Witch Project. For some reason, I love that movie. I have it on DVD, and I really wanted to find this one on DVD too, but I'm really happy to have it at least on cassette, because I love this movie, and I can't wait to watch this, actually. But I'm probably going to watch the first one again. Just because it's been a couple of years since I've seen it, actually. I bought it on DVD. First time I saw it on DVD, I think I paid full price for it, too. I think I paid like $15 for it. But, Yeah, so I'll probably go watch that and then watch this eventually. This is actually one of my more sought-after movies for some reason. Like, it was just one that I always just kind of... always kind of hoped that I found. So when I found this in the thrift store the other day, I was just so stoked. So definitely awesome to have that. Okay. A couple other things. Then I got some packages that I received. First off, one last movie to show off here. This was actually a movie I just bought. I'd watched a video recently, and I can't remember who it is. Oh, gosh, it's going to kill me because I can't remember. I'd like to give them a shout-out, but I can't remember their YouTube handle. I could just hear the voice and see the channel, but I can't remember the name, so I'll try to put an annotation here of who it is. But they had this movie on Blu-ray, and it's actually a collection of movies. And I was really excited. I was like, wow, you know, I didn't even, you know, I hadn't even really realized. I mean, I kind of thought there was this, but that's a sure thing because I have it. It's the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles collection, and it's the first movie, the second movie, the third movie, and then the animated TMNT. Now, I just bought TMNT not too long ago, on DVD, no less, but I could not buy this package because I absolutely love all three of the live-action Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movies, and I can't wait to watch them again. I just watched the first two on VHS, just like a month ago, but I'm totally ready to watch them again. And it's been a while since I saw the third one, and there's lots of people that knock the third one, but I dig the third one. It's not my favorite of the three. It's my least favorite, but you know, hey, there's only three of them, and I still do really like it. And one last thing that's I got a couple of things here. This is one of the only games I actually got. I bought this at a garage sale a couple weeks ago, and I spent $15. I just talked about this in the podcast. If you listen to the podcast, you already know what this is. I picked up Call of Duty Black Ops 2 for the PlayStation 3. I already had this game for the 360. You know, I'm not the biggest Black Ops or Call of Duty fan of the world. You know, I like it, but not a huge fan, so I certainly don't need two copies. I really just bought this because I know it will make a good trade at GameStop. So, hey, you know, even if I get just the same amount, I guess, you know, it's okay. Hopefully I get a little bit more, because that's kind of why I spent the $15. Otherwise, I could have just spent $15 at GameStop. But hopefully I can get like $20-$25 trade in. I don't even know. I don't know how much it's worth. It doesn't really matter. If I get less than $15, I'll just keep it and try to actually just trade someone for it, for something else. Okay. And then I bought four games on the 3DS eShop, which I have nothing to hold, but I'll just tell you what they are. I picked up Super Mario Brothers, the original. I had a rant about that in the podcast as well. I figure after 25-plus years of Nintendo and Super Mario Brothers 1, they could give that one game away for free, or like 99 cents or something. You know, just $5? Really? Whatever. Maybe it was like $3.99. I don't know. Still, either way, I felt like I overpaid for it. But hey, I fell for it. I bought it. I actually beat it. It's the first time I ever beat Super Mario Brothers. It was awesome. But it's because of the save states. There's like a create a restore point or whatever. So you can like save right before you make that hard jump that you know you're probably gonna miss 5 times, you know, so it's cheating, but hey, whatever, I did it. I beat Koopa. I'm happy. Save the princess. Started the second quest, and the second quest is just way too hard, so next game I beat, or next game I bought, was Legend of Zelda, the first one. I've beaten that one lots of times. I love it. It's one of my very favorite games of all time, so I figured, what the heck, you know, get it on the go. That's cool. I used to have it for the Game Boy Advance, but I got rid of it. But I'm glad to have it as a download on my 3DS because it's on the 3DS, so it doesn't, you know, I don't have to worry about having the cart with it. But I still have the original on the NES, but the battery on it's, like, dead. So I know I can fix that, get a new battery, but whatever. I have it on 3DS now. I don't really need to. I also got Burger Time Deluxe. Awesome. I love Burger Time. It's a fun game. Fun arcade-y style game. and just fun to kill time with, make burgers, smash hot dogs, and yeah, it's awesome. And then I got Liberation Maiden. It's an actual 3DS game. I haven't played it yet. Looking forward to it. Yeah, I hear good things about it. It's a shooter, kind of. Check out some YouTube footage if you want. It's one of the Guild games by Level 5. Pretty awesome. Awesome looking. I haven't actually played it yet. But anyway, moving on. I also bought a computer keyboard to Lenovo. You don't need to see that, though. Not going to pick it up. Bought a headset. Using it on the podcast. Sounds a lot better than my phone used to. I'm trying to think if there's anything else pressing that I just picked up. Not really, a few nicky-nacky things that, you know, you don't really care about. Now on to the good stuff. I received two packages in the mail recently. One, once again, from Mr. T.G. Apuleius, and that is the first one here. We got to talking a little bit on YouTube, of course, about Halo stuff, and I kind of mentioned that I was interested in the Halo novels, and he just tells me, hey, I have some. You want them? Yeah. That guy sends me so much stuff. It's ridiculous. So I picked these up. Well, I didn't pick them up. He sent them to me. He sent me three of the novels. The first one is actually the last book in the Forerunner saga. It is Silentium. So I got that. And then he threw in the first two books in the Kilo 5 trilogy. And that is Grasslands on paperback. And then hard copy of The Thursday War. So there we go. And to make matters more awesome, he decided to throw in a bonus, which is the bonus to end all other bonuses ever. A while back, he had a video where he was, you know, giving away some stuff, and I messaged him, you know, of course, you know, as several people did, and he sent me some games. But he said one of the ones that I had requested, several people were interested, so he was going to have some sort of contest to decide who got it. Okay, so I didn't think much about it. You know, I was hopeful, of course, you know. And so he had his contest, and I won. So he sent me the Halo 3 Legendary Edition. There it is. There's the Master Chief head with the Halo 3 logo right there. And you open up his head here, and just take his head off. And it's got a cool little stand, and the games actually fit in there, but I don't keep them in there, so that came in a huge box, but I've got the box already displayed up there, so I won't worry about the box for right now, but Chief will reside right there. And of course it came with a copy of Halo 3, and it's got this special edition cover. Still shrink wrap, haven't opened it yet. Probably won't, actually, to be honest. And then they have the Halo 3 Essentials disc. I might open this one because I want to know what's on here. Maybe I'll just YouTube it, see what's actually on this disc. It's not that I'm ever going to get rid of it, you know, but it's kind of cool to keep it sealed, especially the games. I really don't need to open this. I have Halo 3. I've played it. I've beat it. But this has kind of rekindled Halo 3 for me, so I might play it again. I'm playing Halo 4 right now with my good friend Pierce Jedi. We started playing it co-op a little bit. And, TG sent me a note, too, covering up his name, because he didn't like people to know his name. He said, "So I heard you like Halo. Enjoy. P.S. Congratulations. You won." That's a cool note, dude. Thank you very much. I you already know how appreciative I am. We've already talked about this on email, so thank you once again, man. You really, really didn't have to, and yeah, you're too awesome. Yeah. Anyway, back to my friend Pierce Jedi. We've been talking a while, you know, off and on. We watch each other's channels, and he's a good buddy. And so we decided to work out a little bit of a trade. He was interested in an item that I had for sale. He actually sent me some cash and this stuff, and I sent him some stuff. I'll link his channel in the description. So I don't think he's got it yet as of recording this video, but he should have it pretty soon. So I'll link you to him. So go sub to Mr. Pierce Jedi. Awesome YouTuber, great pickups, and just a cool dude. He sent me one game, sent me a new Super Mario Brothers for the Nintendo DS. It's a repro case, but looks fantastic. I know you were kind of concerned about that in your note, which I'm going to read in a second. The inside, of course, was the game, which is in my DS right now. So there we go. It's new Super Mario Bros. And then you threw in a note, of course, and then this really awesome Serpent Society card. This is Marvel 1992. Very cool, man. I love 90s Marvel stuff, so thank you for that, man. That's awesome. And then the note says, thank you so much for this trade. I'm super stoked. The case is a reproduction I bought on Amazon. It's not perfect, but it's better than a loose game. And sorry, the quality of the cover isn't that great. Scan the download from coverproject.net. Kind of wonky. Hope you like the cheddar bacon pop. It's included as though. I included it as a bonus, though. It is my favorite. Woo! There we go. Cheddar bacon pop. I am so excited for this. This is a fat man's dream right here. Cheddar bacon popcorn. Hell yeah. He said, thanks for joining me on some Halo 4. Totally, man. It was a blast. Totally need to do it again. Definitely will. P.S. My wife doesn't much care for the smell of the popcorn while it's popping, but will eat more than her share of the bowl if I'm not careful. Note taken. And another better. Bacon cheddar popcorn and video games, man. I'm stoked. So thanks so much, Pierce Jedi, and hopefully you enjoy your package. I know you will. It's on its way. It should be there any day now. Like I said, I don't even know when I'm going to open up or upload this video. So, you know, you probably have it by now and are enjoying it. Sorry, there's no bacon cheddar popcorn in your box. I'm going to send some popcorn sometime or something. This must be like the box says that this company is in Seattle, so this must be like a fairly local business to you, or like a local food favorite, I guess. I don't really have too much of that around here, I guess. I kind of live in Podunk, USA, where we don't have much cool. So anyhow, this is about 33 minutes long, and I'm finally out of stuff to show you. Thank you for joining me, of course, on my pickups video. Actually, hey, I just saw some stuff. The only music pickups I got, not that they matter at all. It's Dennis Lee hammering on, the bluegrass dude playing the hammer dulcimer. I know you care about that a lot. And then I picked up the Alan Parsons Project, Eye in the Sky. Love that. I'm a big fan of 70s progressive rock, so love the Alan Parsons Project. Okay, I think now that's it. I could have just not showed you those, but hey. This is a Doomwaves pickup video. What do you expect but the most random stuff ever? Yeah. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you made it all the way to the end and saw my awesome stuff. You got any comments or things you want to discuss about the crap that I bought? You know what to do. Thanks for watching. Doomwaves out.